coming to the symptoms of breast cancer, I mean, how do you actually diagnose a breast cancer, or what are the symptoms for which a patient should come to the doctor? So the most important symptom of breast cancer is a lump in the breast. That is the most significant and most important symptom with which the patient does come. So a lump in the breast should not be neglected. Other than that, any redness or rashes on the breast, that should not be neglected. Then if there are some ulcers or some boils on the breast which have not been healing for a long time, they should not be neglected, and the lady should come and see the breast surgeon immediately. The other symptoms are a discharge from the nipple. Any bleeding, bloody discharge from the nipple should not be neglected. The patient should see the doctor immediately. In addition to that, if they have a greenish discharge or a yellowish discharge, it's usually not in favor of a malignancy, but any kind of nipple discharge should not be neglected, and you must see the breast surgeon immediately. And one more thing is inversion of the nipple or retraction of the nipple. If the lady finds that the nipple is inverted inside or retracted inside, then there could be an underlying cancerous growth in the nipple areola complex growing, which tends to pull the nipple inside. So this is also a symptom which should not be neglected, and the lady must go and see the breast surgeon to rule out any kind of problem in the breast. Breast cancer is probably the leading cancer now among women in the urban setup compared to the rural setup. And there are many causes, or there are many risk factors for breast cancer. So one of the most important risk factors for breast cancer is urbanization. A woman completing 30 years of age and having her first childbirth after completing 30 years of age increases the risk of breast cancer. The other risk factors are women who do not have children. They are at a risk of developing breast cancer due to imbalance of the hormones. Other than that, women who have not breastfed their babies, they are also at a risk of developing breast cancer, because breastfeeding tends to keep the estrogen levels low and keeps the progesterone levels high, which is protective against breast cancer. These are probably some of the risk factors. Other than that, the other risk factors are a family history of breast cancer. So if there are blood relations, like first or second degree relations, who have suffered from breast cancer, then women in the family are at a risk of developing breast cancer and should be on regular screening, which we would be talking about later. The other women who are at a risk of developing breast cancer are lifestyle changes, smoking. That certainly increases the risk of breast cancer, because the toxins in the cigarettes are very hazardous to the epithelium of the mammary cells. So the epithelium is the lining of the breast cells, and that causes certain changes and increases the risk of breast cancer. Regular consumption of alcohol, that also tends to increase the risk of breast cancer, because eventually what happens is the more alcohol a woman consumes, it starts getting converted into fat. And fat is the fuel for the hormone estrogen, which is responsible for breast cancer. So the more fat that is deposited in the body, it gets converted to the hormone estrogen. And as the estrogen levels increase, the risk of breast cancer increases. Other than that, what we have noticed is faulty diet habits could also be responsible. It's a postulated risk, it's a relative risk, like increased fat in the diet, especially saturated fats or tinned food, canned food, food with preservatives, also have some toxins in them, and also packaged foods, they tend to increase, because we have seen patients who have consumed this kind of food over a long duration and have presented with breast cancer. And the other factors, of course, which are very relative, could be either pesticides in the food or could be pollution. These are all, you know, relative risk factors. And also there is another relative risk factor, is they say that people who have a very sedentary lifestyle or obesity with increased fat could be probably one of the relative risks for developing breast cancer. So it is advocated that we adopt our active lifestyle, we exercise regularly, try to maintain ourselves and keep us fit, and be on low-fat diet, eat more salads, healthy food like juices, fresh vegetables, and eat fresh food, which can definitely reduce the risk to some extent.